Welcome for the next lecture for the hydraulic engineering. We are discussing about the notches, spheres and spillways, that is unit number 3. In the previous session, we have discussed about the time required to empty the reservoir by using the rectangular notch or the rectangular veer. And in that, we have derived the equation in terms of the time T and the head H by using the equation, discharge equation of a rectangular veer or a notch. So now, today we are going to derive the equation for the time required to empty the reservoir or tank by using the triangular notch or a triangular veer. Means we are going to establish the relationship between the time T, discharge or equation given by the triangular notch or the veer, in which that head H will be there as a parameter. Okay. With respect to that, we are going to derive that equation and we are going to have discuss some of the numericals associated with it. Just consider a triangular notch or veer as shown in the figure, which is used for the emptying the reservoir or a tank, or to reduce the water level from the initial level to the final level. So initial level we are considered as H1 and the final level we are considered as H2. Then time at the beginning will be the 0 and at the end it will be the T. Okay, so the limits for the T we can say will be from 0 to the T, and for the H it will be from the H1 to the H2 or vice versa. Okay, then for deriving the equation, we are going to use the basic equation, that is for the discharge, that is Q is equals to AR by T, in which A is the area of the cross section of the channel or the tank, and R is the rise that we used to use practically for the measurement of the discharge or for the calibration purpose of the various instruments. Okay, then the time T in which we are getting that particular rise of some magnitude. Then as like here, instead of the rise R, we will have the fall. We will have the falling head instead of the rising. And that is nothing but the H we are considering from the H1 to the H2 in a particular time T. So here we want to have the relationship between the T and H. So I'm going to rearrange that terms. That is, therefore, a T is equals to, it will be A into the H divided by a Q. So that this Q I have taken to this side, I have taken this T to left hand side. Now here we are finding that whenever the time is increasing, then in that case head is decreasing. Head over the crest is decreasing. So there will be the negative sign, we can say. As time increases, the head decreases. Now for the small interval of time dt, we can say there is a fall in the head as a dh. So it means that, suppose that for a small interval of time dt, there is a small fall in the head as a dh, okay, with respect to the time dt. Now, this is our assumption that in a small interval of time dt, the falling head is by a small magnitude of a dh. So with respect to this, now we have to calculate the total time required. We have to find out the relation for the total time required for the reduction of the head or reducing of the head from the H1 to the H2. It means that now for this equation, we'll be required to put up the limits for the T from 0 to the T and for the head, that is from H1 to the H2, isn't it? So it means that for the getting the total time T required to empty this reservoir or to reduce its level from the initial to the final, we'll be required to integrate this one. Because this is a small one and we want to go for the larger one, it means we will be required to go for the integration of the same. So integrating the same, so therefore we will have the integration for dt with respect to the time as a 0 to the t is equals to integral of this minus a into dh by q with the limits for the head now. Here will be from h1 to the h2. Okay. Initial here will be the H1 and the final will be the H2. Okay. Then now here instead of the Q, we are knowing the equation for the discharge passing through the triangular notch or veer. So we are going to put for this equation here. So we'll have the equation as integral over dt will be the T limit from 0 to the T. So it will be a T directly, that is equals to integral from H1 to the H2, okay, initial as H1 here and final as H2 into the minus a dh divided by The equation for the discharge passing through the triangular notch, there is a 8 by 15 CD under root 2G into tan theta by 2 into the power of H as a 5 by 2. Okay. Now for this equation, we are finding that this parameter 8 by 15 CD root 2G and tan theta by 2 are the constant, and the area A is also the constant one. Okay. Now the parameter which is varying here, it is a head H with respect to the time T. So I am taking the constant terms outside. So therefore, we have the equation for the T as minus A divided by, now 8 by 15, I am rearranging it. It is a 15 by 8. So A into 15 divided by 8 into the CD under root 2G into tan theta by 2. Into tan theta by 2. And I'm taking now this H to the numerator. So it will become as a now at limit as a H1 to the H2 H raised to minus 5 by 2 into dH. Just I have taken this term H raised to 5 by 2 from the denominator to the numerator. Now integrate it, we'll get the relation for that. So therefore, the time t is equals to minus a into 15 divided by minus a into the 15 divided by 8 into CD under root 2G tan of theta by 2 into. Now what is the integration of H raised to minus 5 by 2? What is the integration for the H raised to minus 5 by 2? Power will reduce or power will increase here. Power vaadte ki kami hote integration madhe?
Increases.
Means minus 5 by 2 plus 1 manar, isn't it? It means minus 5 plus 2 by 2 enar. It means it will be minus 3 by 2. So power of H will become as a minus 3 by 2, and the same power is going to be divided. It is a minus 3 by 2. Limit will be from H1 to the H2. Therefore, a time t is equals to 15A minus, I would like to go for minus 15A divided by 8 CD under root 2G tan of a theta by 2. Now I'm taking this minus 3 by 2 outside. So it will be minus 2 by 3. Isn't it? It is dividing here in. So it will become as a minus 2 by 3 into the, I'm going to put up the limits for the H now. H as H1 and, sorry, H2 and H1. So H2 rest to minus 3 by 2 minus H1 rest to minus 3 by 2. Okay, so that is, now again we will be able to rearrange it. So the constant terms, those are going to, those are here, that is a minus sign, minus minus will become plus, then 3 into 5, that is 3 by 15, and this 2 into 4, that is 2 by 4 as a, sorry, 2 4 as a 8. Okay, so the relation we will have as a time t is equals to, now instead of 15, there is the 5. So 5 by 4 into area A divided by the constant terms as the CD under root 2g into tan theta by 2. Okay, tan theta by 2 will be there. Now, this h raised to minus 3 by 2 is there. We'll take to the numerator. So it will become as a 1 by h2 raised to 3 by 2 minus 1 by h1 raised to 3 by 2. Now, from this 3 by 2, we'll be able to take out the one of the h as a common. If you will take it outside, it will look okay. If you are not going to take, then also it's okay. So I am considering this equation also and another one, that is in which we are going to take out this one of the H as a common, that also as the final equation. So what we'll do now in the next equation, we'll just rearrange the terms and we'll go for one of the H as a common. So that will become as a time t is equals to 5/4 into a upon cd under root 2g tan theta by 2 into 1 upon, if I will take one of the h2 as a common from this h2 raised to 3/2, what will the power for the remaining h2? I am taking one of the h2. Kai will raise h2 to power kai will. If you are taking h2 as a common, then remaining h2 will have the power as a 1/2, isn't it? So that is nothing but the root. So h2 into root h2 minus 1/2 into h1 into root h1. This will be the another form of the equation for the time required to empty the reservoir or to reduce the water level from the reservoir or a tank from the initial level h1 to the final level h2 by using the triangular notch or a triangular weir. Now considering the numericals example, those were asked based on the time required to empty the reservoir or tank. Okay, for both the rectangular triangular notch. The first example which we are going to consider, it is was asked in May 17 for the 5 bars. The statement is like this: find the time required to lower the water level from the 5 meters to the 5 meter in a reservoir of a size 90 meter by 90 meter. Okay, it means they had given us as an initial water level as a 5 meter and the final water level as a 4 meter, and it is, and for calculation of the area they are given the dimension of that reservoir as a 90 meter by 90 meter. It means that rectangular portion will be there, and from that reservoir or the tank it is required to find out the time to reduce the water level from the 5 to 4 meter. Okay, with respect to what or by using which instrument? Firstly, they asked by using the rectangular notch of 1 meter crest length. It means that the length of the crest for the notch is a 1 meter. And the second one, that is the right angled triangular notch. It means that the theta will be the 90 degrees. It means that in the relation at theta by 2 will be 45 and tan 45 will be the 1 likewise. And for both the cases, they asked to consider the CD, that is coefficient of discharge, as a 0.62. Okay. So what we'll do, we'll go for firstly the data which is given to us. So write down the given data, it includes the h1 and h2. So which one is h1 and which one is h2 here? H1, is it 5 meter or 4 meter?
5 meter.
Right, h1 is a 5 meter, h2 as a 4 meters. Then for calculation of the area of the reservoir, they had given the dimension as a 90 meters by 90 meters. It means that the area will be the 90 into 90. So how much it is now? 90 by 90. 8100, na?
Ha, sir.
8100 square meters. And coefficient of discharge as a 0.62. And what they asked to calculate? They asked to calculate the time required t. Firstly, by rectangular notch or weir, and secondly, by a triangular or a right angle weir we can or notch. Here they have specifically mentioned that is by using the notch. So we'll consider a notch only. So first we will go for the t by a time required to lower this level from 5 meters to the 4 meter by the rectangular notch. So consider firstly t required for rectangular notch. So now write down the equation. What is the formula? We know. Now what is the equation? Formula again. T is equals to for a rectangular notch. Is you are remembering? T is equals to thrice A divided by CD into L under root 2g, okay, into 1 upon root of h2 minus 1 upon root of h1. So therefore t is equals to, what are the values? Therefore a time t is equals to 3 into area as a 90 by 90, that is a 8100, divided by cd as a 0.62, into the crest length also they had given to us, that is l is equals to 1 meter. So into 1 into under root 2g, that is a 2 into 9.81. as unit for area we have considered as in a meter per second square, and h is also as a meter, so g will consider in meter per second square, that is 9.81, into 1 upon root of h2 is a 4, minus 1 upon h1 as a 5. So just do the calculations, you will get the time required to empty the reservoir by using a rectangular notch. Time will be in a seconds, because unit for the g is a meter per second square. By taking the root, it will become as a second, here as a meter square. So this meter square, then this length as a meter, and this here as a meter, sorry, root of meter from the 9.81, and here head. So unit here meter, root meter, which meter meter cancel will, it will be the seconds. So how many seconds?
Sir, this is H2 5 and H1 4 ahi ikade.
H2 4 ahi baro rahi. H2 is a 4 and H1 is a 5. Is it correct?
Answer.
Okay. So what is the answer then? Is anyone has got the answer for the time required to empty this reservoir? Okay. So is it that 467.07 seconds? So that is a 467.07 something seconds. This is the time required to lower the water level from the 5 meters to the 4 meter by a rectangular notch. Similarly, we will go for the time required to the empty the reservoir, sorry, to reduce the level, water level from the reservoir from the 5 meters to the 4 meter by using a triangular notch. Okay, so T for a triangular notch. What is the equation? What is the relation that correlates the time required with respect to the head from the H1 to the
sir, H2? Sir, the time April answer the order.
Okay. So the equation for the time required for the triangular notch is that T is equals to 5 times area divided by 4 into a CD. Coefficient discharge into 2g into tan theta by 2, okay, into a bracket. I'll get to putting the directly values as a 1 by h2, sorry, we'll go for the equation, 1 by h2 into root h2 minus 1 by h1 into root of h1. Okay, this is our generalized equation. Then now put in the values. So T is equals to 5 times area, that is 8100, divided by 4 into CD as 0.62, into root of 2 into 9.81 into tan theta by 2. And for this case, they have mentioned as a, it is a right angle. So theta is a 90 degree, isn't it? So tan theta by 2 becomes, so tan theta by 2 is a tan 45, and tan 45 is a 1. So I'm directly putting the value here as a 1. Okay, into 1 upon h2 into root h2. H2 is a 4 into root 4 minus 1 by h1 as a 5 into root 5. Just simplify it. You will get the magnitude for the time required to lower this water level by using a triangular notch. Is it 131.09 seconds? 131 point something seconds is you are getting. Is all of you got the same answer? In the roll number 26, I got this one. 131.117 seconds. 131 point something. He got as a 09. It means that the 0, it means the 131.1 seconds, we can say.